Today's fun is going to be Taylor C10 CE 310 CE. Get it right, Dave. But first, we have this. Oh yeah, it's there. Okay, so we're getting to that all-important measurement, the string action height. And I noticed it just looks a little high. I can just sort of tell by seeing it. And when I measure it, it's nearly 2/64 higher than we want it to be on the low E side. And once again, the same there on the treble side. Let's do the neck relief thing. It's got a little bit of fret wear. We're going to correct that. The neck relief, I'm going to believe, is just about right. I'm not going to play with that. That's within the realms of goodness. Sweet! Oh, it went back into record. What are you doing, stupid frickin' thing?
This might have been fun at home, but I'm not having fun with it now. What a mess. Don't do that. Cut them off properly.
Leveled, crowned, polished, oiled. It's all good.
I got to get some strings. Store's not open yet.
Okay, so I'm stabbing a set of elixirs on here. 13 to 56 as recommended by Taylor. Holy robbery. $18 for a set of guitar strings. Somebody help here. $2.07 in sales tax. Suck my sucker.
One high fret spoils the whole bunch. Just on the treble side, too. So, well, let me get a marker and mark that guy. We gotta fix that. Son of a sea cook. No more chatter with the rocker. Okay, let's put these unbelievably expensive strings on this sucker. Well, I think we won again. Taylor 0, Dave 1. Thing about Taylor guitars, and oh, I have to get a pick here, just because they're so very, very even. So it doesn't matter how hard you beat it, it only makes so much sound, and that's, I mean, it's not a bad sound, but that's, I just don't find that the guitars have much dynamic to them. But I'm pretty sure Dylan plays plugged in anyway, so. And don't forget, I still got stickers, you guys. So, make sure you hit me up. Postage donations, and I'll send it right off to you. Cheers.